You find a bunch of performance tweaks, the game updates and removes them, and so the wheel of development continues. Player Unknown's Battleground continues to be a very active multiplayer game, and a set of somewhat recent updates have but severely increased GPU performance and broken my older videos. Not to worry, since the internal resolution scaler is still unlocked in the configuration file, and the game is now optimized enough that you can play in some IntelHDs if you're drastic enough. And if you have dropped all the settings to the lowest, you have likely noticed that the screen scale, which is a weird name for an internal resolution scaler, seems to only go down to 70. You can drop it to much lower than that by going into the configuration file located in your user folder, app data, remember to enable hidden folders, DSL game, saved, config, Windows No Editor, and the file is called gameusersettings.ini. Two lines control the internal resolution, SG resolution quality, and screen scale. I have already mentioned in a previous video how this can actually make the game playable on something like the Intel UHD 620 on the Dell XPS 13, but a lot of people were asking me to have this on a separate video, so naturally I wanted to try something weaker. Here I have a pre-release unit of the GPD Win 2, a handheld gaming device powered by an M3 CPU and its IntelHD, and the worst thing that has happened to my sleep schedule in a while. For this one, I dropped the internal resolution to a pixelated 20%. The advantage of reducing internal resolution is not only that the UI is still perfectly readable, but that the low resolution is sampled back into the display resolution. But that does not help a lot when you go this low. While long-distance visibility is screwed at this resolution, the performance was a big surprise. The game was one of the heaviest things I used to test, and this portable IntelHD device manages to maintain over 20 FPS, and often more between open field and closed down areas. It will still suffer from temporal stuttering and drops in certain parts of the map, and looking at the usage numbers, it appears that these are either caused by a slow CPU or, surprisingly, a lack of memory. Since part of the RAM is already being used as VRAM by the BIOS, 8 gigs of RAM might not be enough. Still, it is a pretty impressive result given the conditions. Thank you for sticking around for this short video as I make time to put together a couple of more complex experiments. And thank you if you have decided to donate in Patreon to facilitate some of those future endeavors.